I mean, one lap of this is 2.5 miles, so just play practice mode and do what? However many laps. To 1,000 laps. It's less than 1,000 laps, but you know, it's gotta be 1,000 laps.
Final lap.
That's a wall. Finally get some variety of music. Listening to the sun mode track for the last 3 hours or whatever. That's right. Worth it. Have everything unlocked. Almost everything unlocked. At least all vehicles unlocked. Dang it. Trying to hit that speed boost. That's too bad. It's wrecked. I could have interrupted it. I can save it. The vehicle I'm using is the one you unlock for getting all silver and gold coins on every track, both racetracks and stunt tracks. So you think it'd be the best, right? I imagine so. But then there are vehicle parts that make your car faster, handle better. I don't have all those yet. 1,200 more miles, or so. Then I'll have everything. Trying to see, I've completed 5 circuits. It might be 100 miles per, maybe a little more than 100 miles per circuit. It's 8 tracks, or not 8 tracks, but 8. 8 races.
laps to go.
I think that was second crash. The circuit crashing's not good. Axel. Nice. Yeah, this is a lot of fun. This whole series, the whole Rush series in general. Finally unlocked all the vehicles. Hopefully see some nice time improvements. I should mention that the leaderboards allow to use cheats to unlock all cars, all parts, all vehicle parts. Vehicle parts increase top speed, handling, all that good stuff. But I've decided to unlock everything, even though I did use other cheats to unlock some of the cars, but that's alright. That's frustrating. I had to add an issue with one of my controller packs got corrupted. I had to wipe all the save data, including unlocks for Rush 1 and 2, a little bit of this one, so hopefully it doesn't happen again. Definitely frustrating. I mean, if I had a jump, I need to fix my adjustment error, I will, but not very often. I don't say I ever need to use them, but if I take a jump at a weird angle, I'll deploy the wings. There you go. There's some wings. Yeah, I like that. Nice. Oh. That's not good. Thanks, and then I messed it up. Going through the grass. It's alright. It happens. Hey, I was trying to see if there's... You can go forward. Through that section that's blocked off. Uphill. Zigzag. There's a little gap. I think if you take it too fast, you're gonna hit a brick wall. Or just a wall. Maybe. Might be worth it. Just gotta take it a bit slower up the hill. Yeah, it's all looking cool. I'm way behind now. Oh, that's alright. It looked cool. And I didn't crash. Oh yeah, oh yeah. I think that's better. Just gotta take it at the right speed. I think I just passed the 800 miles. Unlocked another vehicle part. 800 miles total. I need to get to 2,000 to unlock everything. Just gonna take some time. Careful. Oh, I tried taking that ramp, but it never worked out very well. It's a little too fast up that hill. Yeah, I'm still learning a bit about this run. I definitely know more about the first. Know more about the first rush than the other two. I played that one probably the most. And I only have run in beginner circuit. This one's different in that there are different divisions. Four different divisions: beginner, intermediate, expert, advanced, or advanced expert. Yeah, beginner, intermediate, advanced, expert. Compared to Rush 1 and 2, where there's a set number of tracks per circuit, and then there are four variations per track. That makes up the entire circuit, so 24 races total in the first game, and I think 32 in the second. And this one, beginner, has four tracks, two variations, eight races total. Leap Intermediate has 10 races, and Advanced has 12, but haven't played those yet. Or at least for speed runs. It's gonna help. Same thing last time. Yeah, they definitely do But I think that's the case for all three games. It does make it a bit more balanced. Gives you a chance to catch up. AI taking corners too fast, just prone to crashing. Don't think I hit first, but. Got a chance for a second here. Yeah, this definitely feels tougher. Even on beginner compared to, for beginner they're very difficult. It doesn't seem like there's really even I think that would be some sort of difficulty increase, but I think it's just the number of tracks determines.
back.
I was muted, sorry. Thanks. I was saying that the... Yeah, I muted. I was saying that the screeching of the tires persists sometimes. Go ahead and save those. Cool. Time. It's new engine. Probably gonna stop soon. Maybe I should do an intermediate race. Intermediate circuit. Yeah, no problem. Yeah, unfortunately, if you're interested in speedrunning, unfortunately, emulator is banned. So you have to play on original hardware. This is the N64 version, but there's also Dreamcast, if you have that. Okay, you got N64, nice. Yeah, you just need a capture card that can... You have to get a capture card. Which would be... something that'll do composite input. Or if you have S video cables, that. Yeah. There you can find a... You can find an adapter that'll do analog... whether it's composite or component.